So today in our prayer journal challenge, we are talking about one facet of prayer that many, many Christians have a hard time remembering, and that is confession. And it's no surprise because confession, it's kind of like going to the dentist, you know, like it's never fun, but it's good for you. And so I feel like that's probably why it gets ignored more than it should. But if you begin a regular habit of confession in a prayer journal, it can be great for your spiritual health. Because then instead of just waiting for things to get really, really bad, like, you know, your tooth is decaying and you've got a fever and you can't think because it hurts so much, you go in for your regular cleanup, deal with the issues before they get big, kind of like weeding the garden, right? If you're out there every couple days taking care of the little weeds, they're not going to have time to go into big major weeds. And confession is like that. If we're regular and deliberate about confessing our sins, then they're not going to have the opportunity to grow until they're so big we don't know what to do with them. So what I have up here is a copy of 1 Corinthians 13. In the NIV, we're going to use this verse as a springboard for confession. Most of you will be familiar with the passage right here. Love is patient, love is kind, and so on. And I will leave this up to you. If you want to journal these things out in shorthand, that's probably what I would do. So for an example, what I would do is on one line of my journal, I would write patience. And then I would write the times that come to mind that I need to confess where I was not patient. Then I would go and do the same thing for kind. I would write the word kind, and then after that, write the things that come to mind, areas in my life where I know I haven't been kind. Confession can also be confessing our temptations to the Lord. Not that we need to be forgiven for the temptation, but we're confessing our weakness and admitting our need for Him. So you might say, God, I confess it's hard for me to be kind to Sally because of blah, blah, blah. Please help me to be more kind to her. And so you can go through it like that, more of shorthand, or you could just let this be the template for a letter to God. God, I'm sorry for the times when I haven't been patient, like when I did this, this, and this. I am also sorry for the times when I wasn't kind, like when I did this, this, and this. Now, it's very possible that for some of these things, a specific sin isn't going to come to mind. And that's when you can, A, do a little bit more self-exploration to see if, you know, maybe there is something you just haven't thought of and ask God to bring things to mind. B, even for example, let's say you can't think of a specific time when you've been envious lately, but you know that historically you've had a hard time envying this particular kind of person, or you've had a hard time struggling with envy in this kind of situation, you can ask God to help you. Or it could just be a blanket, God, help me to remember not to boast. Like if you literally and genuinely cannot think of a time that you've boasted, you don't need to be inventing sins to confess. But you can say, God, I need your help to not be boastful. And especially if you have situations in mind, like when I'm giving this presentation at this meeting, help me to not be boastful. The more specific you get, the more you can kind of be focused on some of the areas that might be trouble areas for you. So let's just focus on this paragraph here. It's going to take everybody a different amount of time, so take as long as you need. One thing I want to encourage you with all of these exercises, it's kind of easy to just say, oh, well, I get what she's saying. I'll just go ahead and pray that in my mind, which kind of defeats the purpose of doing a prayer journal challenge. But I totally get that, you know, you might be listening to these videos when you're on the road, when you're on the go, but I do encourage you to, even if you don't do it right now, to come back to it, but it's easiest to just do it right now while it's on your mind. So be using 1 Corinthians 13 as a springboard for confession, going through this paragraph here, and I hope that it's a blessing for you. I just want to remind you and encourage you, this isn't about beating ourselves up, or like I said before, about inventing sins to confess. But really just to get our hearts clean before God. You know, let's go back to the dentist analogy, to get that plaque, you know, scraped off before it has time to build up and do some major damage. And that's all for today. We'll see you next time.